Previously on Hell's Kitchen.
Here we come, baby.
20 chefs from all across America arrived in L.A. anxious to begin the competition.
Are we there yet?
And were greeted with their first surprise.
I want you to come to me in Las Vegas.
We're going to Vegas!
After a special VIP tour, they got an even bigger surprise.
For the first time ever, the Signature Dish Challenge will happen in front of a live audience.
What?
Right behind you, coming down.
And to win this damn thing.
2, 1, and stop.
During judging.
Wow, wow, wow.
Janelle.
Thank you, Chef.
Yes.
John.
You've managed to nail it. Very good.
And Cindy.
That's delicious.
Impressed Chef Ramsay.
Thank you, Chef.
While Sebastian.
That is disgusting.
Danielle.
What happened in that kitchen should have stayed in that kitchen.
Gina.
Did you pick this up at the buffet?
And Dan.
Did you throw up on that plate?
Made a different kind of impression.
Zach and Jacqueline, let's go, guys.
It all came down to the final two dishes.
This is really close. Congratulations, ladies. Great job.
We the winner. We the winner. We was the winner tonight. Woo!
The victorious women received the royal treatment at Caesar's Palace.
I cannot believe we met Celine Dion.
While the men slummed it back to Los Angeles.
Hot in here, man.
On an uncomfortable.
I think one of the reasons that they really beat the out of us today.
And monotonous.
I want to throw Sebastian right out the window. He just talks too much.
8.5-hour ride on a school bus.
We really got to focus on trying to.
Oh my God. Sebastian, time out.
After returning from Vegas, the women settled into their Hell's Kitchen dorms. And discovered there is another chef on their team.
What's the matter with you?
We gotta study.
It's a nicer place.
Bitch, who brings a puppet in Hell's Kitchen?
On the first day in the kitchen,
let's start working.
The men are determined to bounce back from defeat.
Dinner service coming up. We gotta come out swinging, because we're not taking another one to the chin like that.
But on the women's side, Gina is struck with a mysterious illness.
I can't function.
Are we operating without Gina?
Medic!
Find out right now if she's out of the competition.
Do you need to go to the emergency room?
Tonight on Hell's Kitchen. Now, the continuation of Hell's Kitchen. The doors have not yet opened for dinner service.
Gina, what's going on?
I can't function.
And Gina is already feeling the pressure.
I'm sorry that I'm doing this, but...
No, let's go. Let's go back here. Sit down right here.
Medic! Medic!
Can you tell me your name? Do you know where you are right now?
I was, like, standing in line, and I was getting overwhelmed.
Okay. You feeling okay right now?
Yeah, like my mind's wandering about all stuff right now. I need just to relax my system.
You're not dizzy or anything?
No, I just don't want to be in a kitchen.
Let's go, ladies.
While the red team shucks, scrapes, and slices in preparation for the impending dinner service.
Now we man down. What are we gonna do? We gonna pull it together.
Up in the dorms, Gina focuses on Gina.
I need to be away from everything, away from all my teammates, and concentrate just on myself and get myself together.
While the red team has lost a chef, in the blue kitchen...
Did anybody see how he heated up the potato puree?
One chef is just lost.
He's got the potato right here. He's got the leeks right here. It's ready to go.
This is Bass. We'll put Bass working side by side with Jeremy. I'm going to tell you, I think his inexperience shines through.
I don't know how to make a polenta.
I'm just a little concerned right now.
Man, I don't myself right now.
While Jeremy struggles to keep up in the blue kitchen, in the red kitchen...
How we feeling?
Good.
The women are moving full speed ahead, despite being down a chef.
Are we going to win tonight?
Yeah.
I definitely think that without Gina here, we are a stronger team.
You good, baby?
I'm good, mama.
We don't have that dead weight dragging us down.
Let's go, ladies.
I just needed a rest, and I'm going to bounce back really fast. All right, Jacqueline, so what did I miss?
What'd you miss? You missed everything.
Right, ladies, let's go.
Yes, chef.
Guys, line up. Let's go quickly. We are opening Hell's Kitchen for the 11th time. Yes. Oh, yes. Yeah. It's a big one.
Let's do it.
Let's be honest. I'm not looking for perfection. Let's get that right. But I am expecting each and every one of you to give your best and for every customer to be fed. So I'm guaranteeing a complete dinner service. How's that sound?
Yes, chef.
Guaranteed.
Oh, my God. This is our first night of Hell's Kitchen. That's not an easy thing to do.
We will stop at nothing to complete a service.
Sorry, chef.
Oh, come on, JP.
Oh, my God. JP, where has he been for 3 years?
I told you to be here yesterday.
Got delayed. I really tried to be in time.
Get changed, JP. I'm pissed off. Honestly, unreal. Okay, get on your stations. Let's go, guys. Open Hell's Kitchen.
Yes, chef.
Let's go, guys. Come on, let's go.
Tonight is the grand reopening of Hell's Kitchen.
The Wellington.
The hell of it.
And in addition to his classic menu, Chef Ramsay has added a tableside appetizer of ale steamed mussels, which will be served by Amanda in the red section of the dining room and by Christian in the blue section.
And it's accurate.
JP.
Yeah?
I need the tickets.
Yes, chef.
Yeah, you disappear for 3 years, and then you turn up late.
Sorry.
How rude. Okay, ladies, on order. First ticket in. 3 covers, table 31. 2 burrata, 1 scallops, 1 mussels.
Yes, chef.
Okay, do you have a spatula?
Where's the ones that flip the scallops with?
What?
Where's the other ones?
That's these ones. Crazy Gina, she doesn't know what she's doing. She hasn't been here all day. Now she wants to cook scallops. Really?
Gina's in La La Land, flipping the scallops a million times. You know, it's a simple sear. One side, other side, that's it.
Over and over.
Come on.
Don't flip it back over. Don't flip it back over.
You ready, scallops?
Yes, ready.
All right, walk it, girl, walk it.
God only knows what these scallops are gonna be like. This is not the way the Red Kitchen wants to start.
Who cooked the scallops?
Here we go. We're already gonna get laid into.
Who cooked them?
I did, chef.
Ugh. Excellent. Thank you.
These are the immaculate scallops. How does this happen?
Good job, girl. Good job.
To the shock of her teammates, Gina has delivered perfect scallops.
Told you I can cook scallops.
While in the blue kitchen, the men can't even deliver.
On order. 2 risotto, 1 mussels, 1 scallops.
A response.
The correct response is, yes, chef. The blue team's response is...
Guys!
Yes, chef!
Thank you.
For all the appetizers to be delivered to the first table at the same time, Sebastian on appetizers in the kitchen must be in total sync with Christian in the dining room.
Would you guys like that spicy or mayo?
Oh, a slight kick.
Slight kick.
Just start rocking a little pan. I've worked in different restaurants. I know how to make risotto, but, like, I've never really focused much on cooking Italian food. I'm not putting it down, it's just like I'm Mexican, so I like those spices more.
Sebastian, how long?
Walking in now.
Thank you. There you go.
Can I come, Scallops? Walking
through? Scallops, walk.
Thank you. Scallops, walking by the pass. Excuse me, gentlemen. Excuse me, chef.
Behind you, chef. Hi.
That's four.
All of you, come here, quick. And I mean, quick. Spoon, taste.
Oh, my God. Here we go. Please, no.
Our first ticket.
Undercooked.
These are undercooked.
Yeah. Regroup and get it together.
Yes, chef. Yes, chef. We're getting it together, chef. Getting it together.
Zach, the scallops will cook beautifully.
Thank you, chef.
I don't know what to do. My muscles are ready. So I said, it. Put it right in front of me. Enjoy, guy. I'm really pissed right now. I'm doing my part out there, and my team can't get the first table together.
Oh, and by the way, the mussels have been served to the table.
While Sebastian starts over on the risotto, Gina,
Nandra, how long for the risotto?
I need 5 minutes on risotto.
Is anxious to prove her earlier success was no fluke.
How long on that risotto, Nandra? Nandra, you almost done?
Bitch, I just told you 5 minutes. I know how long it takes to cook scallops.
Scallops, how long?
How long for that risotto?
How much longer? How much longer? Shut up, Gina.
Nandra.
Nedra won't tell me anything.
Scallops going in. So I'm whipping up the scallops. Scallops ready.
No. I need 2 minutes on risotto. 2 minutes. You crazy bitch. Why did you cook the scallops? Walking with risotto.
Walking scallops.
Right behind you, Chef Hop.
All of you, come here. Let me show you a little waterfall.
Gosh.
Just touch them. Cold, overcooked.
Switch up scallops, guys. Mary, do you want to do scallops?
I'll do
it. No, I want to do scallops. Somebody else has got to do risotto.
What do you mean?
Oh, hell no. Gina, don't throw me under the bus because your ain't right. How long on scallops?
Now drop, just off.
You got some good color on there? Don't burn it.
This bitch couldn't cook a scallop to save her life. I know that chef is about to find out.
I got the scallops ready.
Go, Gina, you gotta go.
Walking scallop, chef.
Mm-hmm. Good luck to you, Gina.
Risotto, right behind you, chef. Hot.
Pause. All of you, come here. I guarantee a complete service tonight. You can't even hold it together for the second ticket. Get out, Gina. Nedra, the risotto was delicious.
Thank you, chef.
Let's go, ladies.
Beep, beep, woo.
Nedra, how many minutes?
5 minutes. Okay, that was two minutes ago.
I am so pissed. Those little bitches, they better watch out. There's gonna be war.
It's opening night in Hell's Kitchen, and the red team.
Get out, Gina.
Once again finds themselves Gina-less in the kitchen. While on the blue side.
Okay, risotto's ready, brother.
Scallops walking up to the pass.
The men are finally ready to impress Chef Ramsay with their second attempt on the first order of appetizers.
Come on, guys. Service, please.
Here we go. Come on.
Blue team is on a roll.
Second ticket. Keep it rolling, guys. Two cappellini, one scallops, one mussels. How long?
I need 60 seconds.
We are finally gelling together as a team.
Walking.
Scallops walking up to the pass. Excuse me, chef.
Taste that. How hot is that?
Spice.
All of you, taste that. It's too spicy and it's disgusting.
Fresh.
And again, scallops cooked beautifully.
What the f is going on? It's like deja vu in this.
How many times have you cooked scallops tonight and not served them?
Twice, chef.
Sorry, bro.
Sebastian, get it together.
Yes, chef.
Come on, guys, let's go.
Okay, Mikey Wikey. I messed up a few times, but I'm getting in with the groove. I'm playing around, trying to make the environment a little bit looser. Zachy,
we got
talk to me.
Halibut, one Brazino.
Zachy, wacky.
Hey, you. Hey, come here, you. Zachy, wacky.
Chef Zach.
Hey, look at me. Hey, look. Is this a joke?
No, chef.
Zachy, wacky.
Sorry, I apologize about that, chef.
Yeah, do me a favor. Get out.
Yes, chef.
Off, will you? Get out!
Yes, chef.
Upstairs, get out!
So Sebastian gets kicked out. We didn't see that coming.
Zacky wacky.
What are you doing?
Where the hell are you going, Sebastian? Okay, yeah, you can come back.
Second time, get out!
God, are you kidding me?
Off. Wacky!
The blue team is now down a chef, and it's up to John to handle the appetizer station solo.
I need 2 minutes, please.
While in the dining room...
My blue team's backed up a little bit, so I'll give you the mussels.
Okay.
Christian is successfully serving mussels.
Will I still get the risotto?
Whether the diners ordered them or not.
I just started going to the table that had their food waiting for so long to try to help our blue team out. I go, I apologize for the clumsiness of my team, and hope you guys enjoy.
Welcome to risotto, guys!
Meanwhile, with Gina gone, the red team is cranking out the appetizers.
Go, please. Yeah, asparagus.
Now, it's up to Jessica and Cindy on the meat station and Danielle and Susan on garnish to keep up the momentum.
On order, 4 covers table 51. Entree, 1 chicken, 1 short rib, pasta, 2 Wellington.
Yes, chef!
I don't understand how you're expected to remember all the tickets.
6 covers away, table 30. Entree, 2 halibut, 1 bass, 1 pork, 1 lamb, 1 Wellington.
Yes, chef!
Yes, chef.
You okay?
I've never worked in a brigade before.
Oh, really?
Never.
I cannot believe that Danielle is a head chef. A head chef of what? A hot dog stand? 3 risotto, 2 burrata?
Let's go. What are you reading that for, Danielle?
I was trying to see if that was the ticket to see what you had just called.
Where's your ticket that I've just called?
Well, it's supposed to be here,
and if it's not there, let's walk 3 steps together.
Yes, chef.
1, 2, 3.
Yes, chef.
And it's that. You're making such hard work out of nothing.
I have no idea why Danielle can't get it together. I'm embarrassed for her.
3 steps. First ticket, second ticket.
Chef.
Okay?
Yes,
no
chef.
Off.
Yes, thank you.
While Danielle gets a lesson in Kitchen 101, on the blue side...
My risotto's ready to walk, dude.
Yeah, let's go.
John, without the help of Sebastian...
Good. Service, let's go.
...has gotten the men back on track.
Thank you, buddy. It looks really nice.
And they are now ready to move on to entrees.
2 lamb, 2 Wellington. 5 minutes to the window.
Yes, chef. 5 minutes in the window. I'm pretty excited about working meat tonight. I decided that I was going to do the lamb and Barrett. He has the Wellington. Wellington's in. I cook lamb every day. I mean, we run it for specials. I was even thinking about putting it on my next menu. Jeremy, 2.5 out on 2 lamb and 2 Wellington.
All right, got it.
I need to still cut it.
You don't think that's still raw?
No, once it rests, bro. All right.
Ready to go?
Put it in the pass. I know my lamb's perfectly cooked, so I don't think we have anything to worry about.
Let's roll.
Yeah, hey, come here, come here.
Oh, my God.
Got 2 on refire, Jeff.
You gotta be kidding me, man. Like, suddenly I don't know how to cook. Firing another Wellington.
While the blue kitchen waits for a do-over on Michael's lamb, over in the red kitchen...
Keep it going, yeah? 2 Wellington, 1 lamb. How long?
6 minutes, chef.
Let's go.
Chef Ramsey is looking for Cindy and Jessica to deliver on the meat station.
You putting your lamb back in?
No.
We gotta brown off the crust, and then we gotta let it rest before we slice it.
Oh, you're right.
Jessica's fresh out of culinary school, so this could be the disaster.
Lamb!
Lamb, slicing.
It's ready to go. She basically just has to slice and walk. This is not rocket science.
Seriously, slice the lamb. How long does it really take?
How much of an amateur are you?
Where's the lamb?
Just cut through it, babe, cut through it.
I'm trying.
Oh my God, this bitch been cutting lamb for 6 hours now. Bitch, it's only 24 hours in a day.
I want that lamb now.
Right behind, right behind.
Lamb rising. Lamb chef.
Oh, mother. Who cooked the lamb?
Me, chef.
Perfect.
Thank you, chef.
Who would have thought? Girl can cook some meat.
Chicken, walking.
While the red team pushes out entrees.
Service, let's go.
It's great. Thank you so much.
Over in the blue kitchen.
Garnish, 2 lamb, 2 yep. Wellington.
Barrett's refired Wellingtons.
We're good.
Are perfectly cooked. But Michael's lamb.
Guys, I'm not sending it out under.
Could use a little more time.
I gotta go with these. Don't go up there yet, bro. The lamb's not ready. Michael's lamb's not ready.
Come on, guys.
I'm waiting on the lamb, chef. I'm sorry.
You're waiting on the lamb?
Yeah.
I was waiting for the lamb, waiting for the lamb, waiting for the lamb. It's like medium. It's not medium anymore.
You need to go.
Yeah. Hold on. Wait for me.
Can't rest no more. We gotta go.
Guys, walking to Wellington.
Me, man.
Barrett, thanks for that, buddy.
I just can't believe this is happening right now.
Lamb! Come on, Michael, a bit of energy.
Yes, Chef.
Terrible and embarrassing.
Oh, God.
It's coming back.
Time out! Stop! The bone thicker than the meat.
There needs to be meat on there. This is not a dog's chew toy. This is lamb.
And if that's not bad enough, they're way overcooked.
Horrible.
Michael and Barry, dumb and dumber.
You don't slice the Wellington until the lamb's ready.
Yes, Chef.
And when it's together like, oh, you.
Chef, can I please come back, Chef?
Dude, really? What are you doing? Perfect timing.
You come here, you. You're making me look stupid.
No, Chef.
The blue team, 1 hour into service and not one entree out. You, for the last time, take him and him and get out!
It's just over an hour into Hell's Kitchen's opening night, and the blue team has failed to deliver a single entree to the dining room.
How much longer can it be?
And the unwelcome return of Sebastian...
Chef, can I please come back, Chef?
You come here, you.
...has pushed Chef Ramsay to the limit.
You, for the last time, take him and him and get out! And let me tell you something. You come back downstairs again, you'll be leaving through the front door. Now get out!
Yes, Chef.
Three of you. You, on meat.
Yes, Chef.
You, on meat.
Yes, Chef.
Oi! Get out!
Now I'm pissed off. I didn't do anything to get kicked out of this dinner service.
Chef Ramsay looks to Ray and Anthony to step up and rescue the meat.
They've already cut. Close them up.
But over in the Red Kitchen...
Where's the kale?
He's looking for something else.
Kale?
Yes, Chef.
Black kale for the lamb. Look at you both staring. You don't even answer me, Danielle.
Danielle, get it together.
She's cooked the lamb perfectly in garnish. Where's the kale? Come on, Danielle!
I'm trying. I've never done this before.
I need the kale. Protein's nailed perfectly, and we're missing a kale. Danielle!
It absolutely will
yes,
be
Chef.
1 minute.
Yes, Chef. Just lightly tossed. Danielle's all over the place. She doesn't know what she's doing.
Like that?
More along this color. I'm spending more time babysitting Danielle than I am worrying about my own garnish.
Finally. Ladies! Touch them.
Parsha.
Oh, my God. That's my garnish.
Who cooked them?
I did, Chef.
Yeah, you. Get out. Get out. Hey, madam. You think it's funny?
No.
Take your with you.
I know that this is not funny. I don't deserve to be kicked out of the kitchen. Danielle does. She was the one bringing the station down.
Danielle, don't stop the redo.
Yes,
Hurry
Chef.
Up. After that, two chicken, two Wellington.
Two chicken, two Wellington. Yes, Chef. Sorry, Chef. I'm confused. Do you need the one for the redo and the two chicken and two Wellington? Or do you just need the two chicken and two Wellington?
Get out! Get out!
It's really hard, and it's a lot harder than people know.
While the women look for someone to step up on the garnish station...
Let's go! Someone help! We gotta get this chicken garnish going!
Chef Ramsay...
Blue team, let's go!
...pushes the men to keep the entrees coming.
Walk it, Chef. Two lamb, Chef.
Service, please.
Perfectly.
Keep it rolling, guys. Three halibut, one bass, one chicken. Come on, guys.
Yes, Chef.
Yes, Chef.
I'm looking at Jeremy sauteing off kale. I can see the kale literally catching fire, getting burnt. Chef, turn that down some, Chef.
Yeah.
Yeah, don't even serve that.
I'm not. Worry about your side. Let me do my side, yeah?
What?
Hey, no territory.
It's my station, and I don't need his help. So shut up and do what you're supposed to be doing.
Unbelievable.
Can we go with three halibut, one bass, one chicken?
Yes, 7 minutes to the window.
What are we going with?
Two halibuts and one chicken, Chef.
Three halibuts.
Three halibut and one chicken, Chef.
Three halibut, one bass, one chicken. What are we going with?
The three halibut, the two,
Jeremy, he's telling it to you. Just say it right back, man. Pretty sure birds can do that.
Three halibuts, one bass, one chicken. What's going?
The three halibut, two.
Get out!
Bye-bye, Jeremy.
It's 90 minutes into opening night.
Mary!
Yes, chef.
Garnish!
And with three members of the red team already kicked out of the kitchen.
I've never worked in a brigade before.
The rest of the team is struggling to fill the vacancies.
Send it without potatoes.
Forcing Chef Ramsay to take the unusual measure of sending the entree without the garnish in hopes he will catch up on the order before the diner notices.
Go, please. We'll send the potatoes separate. Right, potatoes with dragon with chorizo, urgently.
Yes, chef. I'm swamped right now. A few of the girls got kicked out, and now I'm on fish. And on top of that, now I'm on the garnish station. Oh my gosh.
Anybody gonna help her? Jacqueline, don't stand there staring. There's always something to do.
Yes, chef.
Chef Ramsay doesn't stress me out. I'm just like, relax, channel the inner zen, and put the water.
Guys, I need to get my bass in. Watch out.
I'm looking at Jacqueline. She's not doing a damn thing right now.
I need water.
Madam.
Quick question. The chicken was delivered on its side.
Yeah, it needs garnish. You're absolutely right. My apologies. Give me 2 minutes. So now the customer's at the window. 7 minutes ago, we served the chicken. And where are the potatoes?
Chef, 30 seconds.
What are you doing?
I had to get my water, chef.
Get out. Get out!
Chef Ramsay told me to get out, and I'm like, all right. I'm gonna go upstairs and rehydrate myself.
Mary, garnish.
Coming, chef.
Thanks to Mary, the red team finally delivers the missing potatoes.
Hot pan, chef.
But in the blue kitchen,
the chicken is going first.
Chef Ramsay finds himself asking a familiar question.
Where's the chicken garnish?
Walk it. Garnish the chicken.
And what about the risotto appetizer?
Yeah, 45 seconds.
Can he be more cooked? Dan, come here. Just touch that.
Hard chef.
Dan, please, come on. We like five people down in the kitchen. I need you, baby.
I know that.
We are going to complete dinner service, no matter what.
The risotto going up. It's risotto.
Oh, man. Look at that there. Stuck to the bottom of the pan.
Man.
John, take Dan and yourself and get the out of there.
When somebody gets kicked out of the kitchen, they put more pressure on the next man. Woo.
Raymond, taste that. Fingers. Spoons are everywhere.
Valencia.
Ray, you just stuck your finger into a risotto in front of Chef Ramsay in Hell's Kitchen. That's just stupid.
You may be the oldest, but out of respect, off.
Yes, chef.
You got to. Blue Kitchen tonight is like being in the middle of a natural disaster. My heart is beating. I'm not feeling good right now. It's getting hot. I start feeling pressure.
You good?
I gotta just breathe, Holmes.
Risotto.
Yeah. Risotto, chef.
Let's taste that. Yeah. Get out. Get out.
Another person gets kicked out, that's like another blow to me. I started to feel something in my stomach. I literally feel my body shutting down.
Where's Zach?
Oh, my God.
Zach keeps leaving the kitchen.
All I'm thinking to myself is, don't go under. Don't go under.
Zach. Zach!
It's 2 hours into the grand reopening of Hell's Kitchen. And in the blue kitchen, Zach is the last man standing. Barely.
I'm feeling dehydrated, it's getting hot, and I'm starting to lose consciousness. Oh my God. Hold on.
Where's Zach?
Zach! Zach! What are you doing?
I'm throwing up for a minute. Shall we just get this out of me, please?
Throwing up.
Try now. Me.
Oh, God. I'm literally telling myself, if you think that, you know, you're going to pass out, guess what? Think again.
Zach. You okay?
Yeah, chef. I'm a monster.
First up, two bass, two halibut.
Yeah, I'm finishing that up. I got it, chef. Chef Zach. Chef Zach.
Bass, Zach.
Hot. Yeah, two bass, chef.
Two bass. Go, please.
As Zach rises from the ashes,
woo, let's do it.
Frustration is rising amongst the 12 ousted chefs.
I got kicked out of the kitchen
because I couldn't repeat back the order.
You got to repeat back the order.
You got to be able to know that.
Dude, communication was crumbling.
It's first of many.
I've been cooking for half my life, okay? I've never worked in a brigade before. There's hardly any restaurants that work that way.
Danielle is making sure everybody knows she hasn't worked in a brigade system before. Guess what? We know. We know this already.
None of us have ever worked in this kitchen before. Curiosity, show of hands. Guys, how many people have worked in a true brigade before?
While Danielle continues to ponder the mystery of the brigade system, downstairs, the red team has finally found their rhythm.
Chicken, walking, kind of chef.
Let's go.
And on the other side, Zach is feeling better, and entrees are flying out of the blue kitchen as well.
Oh, okay. Last ticket, two halibut, two chicken.
Yes, chef. I'm determined to finish service because what don't kill you only make you stronger. I literally threw ice on my chest. Touch this. Ice. Either that or die on the line.
Last table, girls, last table.
Ready, girls? I'm walking.
Coming right behind you.
The asparagus salad, chef.
Service, please.
I'm feeling really good right now. We completed the first dinner service. This is unbelievable.
Here you are, chef. Two halibut, two chicken.
Perfect. Go, please.
I knocked that out the park. Last man standing. Chef Zach is the man tonight.
Tonight, I guarantee that we would complete a dinner service. But I expected all of you to be here when I finished. It was a difficult evening, but I will choose a winning team. The red team. Congratulations. Zach, you gave it your all.
Yes, chef.
That's the kind of commitment I want to see. Each and every service, all of you, it's gonna get harder. Blue team, time to do something that you couldn't do tonight. I'd like each and every one of you now to work as a team and decide which two chefs you'd like to nominate to get the out of here tonight. Off.
Yeah, chef.
My team, they let me down. But I guarantee you, the guilty parties will be penalized to the utmost.
The two stations that dropped their ball was Sebastian's station and Michael Amit's.
As far as Michael, I agree. I did the Wellington because he said he was ready with the limb. Michael was a disaster. He's an executive chef. He's been doing it for a while. Michael, you should know better. What's the matter with you?
I know I f***ed up lamb, but at the same time, I've cooked thousands of racks of lamb in my life, and I have a lot of experience to bring to the table. Now, with that being said, I'm gonna go with Sebastian. I mean, you gotta know when to be serious and put your head down. You know what I mean? And, you know, you gotta know when to joke around. Sebastian really needs to hit the bricks. This guy's a clown. I haven't seen him serious for a second since he's been here.
I like to have a good time at work, man.
I do, too. I like to make jokes. I like to have a good time. But when it's in the kitchen, man, you got to crunch. When you came in three times and then I got kicked out.
What the f*** were you thinking, man? Coming back in three times?
There was only a second time.
No, you came back a third time.
It's very easy to point fingers. Tonight, we all screwed up. What pisses me off is I wasn't playing around. I was actually trying to put out some good food. Me, I got to nominate Jer. Not because he's not a good cook, but, like, he's not the strongest guy on the team.
I have to second on Jeremy, not because I don't like you, cuz. But, like, what happens tomorrow when we get in service?
You guys know you're voting on me not because I can't cook, but because I couldn't repeat back an order.
Chef, can I tell you why I will vote for you?
Why?
When I see the greens literally turning brown.
But I told you, I got it.
When you talk to me in that tone of voice and with that, you got it.
Worry about your side. Let me do my side, yeah?
Because you were yelling at me. I'm yelling it right back at you.
I did not yell at you. Jeremy reminds me of a young punk with a lot of mouth and nothing to back it up.
You're taking me off because of what I said, but can't cook?
No, you can't cook. You ain't doing it good, playboy.
I'm not doing it good?
You ain't doing it good.
I'm 22. I got a lead position. Watch when I step on you when I'm bigger.
Walking on something and you ain't nothing.
Holmes.
Because you stepping on me real hard, bro.
None of us
he just right stepped now on me real hard. You don't even know where I'm from.
Chef Ramsay has asked the blue team for two nominees. And Michael and Sebastian have been singled out. But another candidate has emerged.
You ain't doing it good, Playboy.
I'm not doing it good.
You ain't doing it good.
You stepping on me real hard, bro.
None of us
he just
right
stepped
now
on me real hard.
You don't even know where the I'm from. Imagine how I feel as a chef knowing I see you doing it wrong and I don't say nothing. What do that make me look like? Now, I know it's you cooking the dish, but what the f*** did that make me look like?
Quit insulting people before you try their food.
You feel like that, chef, then why didn't you say chef? Let it taste it.
I asked everybody to come try it.
Did he ask any of you?
Zach's threw me underneath the bus, but I'm not gonna go down easy. And I'm getting that stupid restaurant in Vegas, and I'll be better than everybody else, and they'll know it.
How are you gonna step on someone's career like that, dude? You're gonna say my career?
You said career. When I said to you, when I said my career, hey chef,
you just
you're not doing that right. From my station, everybody off my station. You did it to yourself, big. The nerve of this guy, cause he knows what the he's doing. Clearly, you the don't got it. Duh, you out of here, homie.
Have you reached a decision?
Yes, chef.
Did you work as a team?
Yes, chef.
Thank God for that. Zach, who is the blue team's first nominee and why?
We had nominated Jeremy because we saw something that wasn't going right with one of the dishes that he was doing, and he refused to take the criticism, telling us to get off his station, and he got it. The mistake of the cooking is one thing, but then the arrogance to not want it to be corrected is something totally different. We can't have that kind of attitude in our kitchen going on.
I'm not asking you to kiss each other's ass, but when you walk into that blue kitchen, you work as a team. Jeremy, were you arrogant? Is Zach right?
No, it wasn't that I was arrogant, chef. I was frustrated at the situation, chef, and I lashed out.
Frustrated and you lashed out. And whilst your frustration's building, you're lashing out, and the customers aren't getting fed. Zach, second nominee and why?
Our second nominee is...
After a rough dinner service where almost the entire team was kicked out of the kitchen, the men have made a tough decision.
We had nominated Jeremy.
But they are not done yet.
Second nominee and why?
Our second nominee is... Sebastian.
Why?
Sebastian is a good guy, but it's a time and a place to play. Zacky wacky in the middle of serve, like, you know, we're trying to execute dishes. We can't have that going on. If you're not serious now, I don't got you getting serious at all.
Jeremy, Sebastian, step forward. Let's go. Sebastian, seriously? You want to f*** around in the middle of service? Why did you come in here?
I love cooking. This is something I love to do, and I've been putting my time. Today, I know I dropped the ball. It's just sometimes my personality comes out in the kitchen. Before I came here, I knew one of my biggest problems, one of my biggest challenges is my attitude, and it's something I have to correct.
Jeremy, you're one of the youngest in this competition. I thought you were in way over your head. Why do you think you should stay in Hell's Kitchen?
Chef, I fought for everything in my life. I've strived to do better. I've always done better, chef. I've succeeded at almost everything I've tried. Today, I failed. I don't plan on failing ever again, chef. to let my team down, and I never do that.
Not only did you let your team down, you then gave them You got yourself in the weeds. You started giving to the team.
That was one comment, Chef.
One comment?
One comment.
Tough call. The person leaving Hell's Kitchen. Sebastian, give me a jacket.
Put the weather set up, come
on. Damn it. It's a kitchen, not a place for comedians. Good night.
Right now, I'm disappointed with myself. I came here thinking that the challenge was gonna be to beat the other chefs and win Hell's Kitchen. And I found a way to defeat myself. Hell's Kitchen, man, it's no joke.
This is not a game for me. This is serious business. Understand?
Yes, yes, Chef.
Get out of here.
Now, this is a fight.
And I'm not leaving. I'm staying.
Only bad thing about winning tonight, we can't send Gina home, but if we lose, she the first sucker that's getting voted off. I'm voting with two hands, and my hoo-ha's count as two, so that's four hands all day.
I can't keep carrying these guys. I can't keep throwing them on my back. The biggest question on my mind is, who's the next I'm getting out of here? Because the star, the head chef here, is Chef Zach.
Sebastian tried to be funny, but it was his cooking that was the joke.
Next time on Hell's Kitchen, the women celebrate their win.
The red team, congratulations.
By having an all-out war.
Let's press the bell, bitch. Don't call me bitch. You crazy. Don't call me crazy. I said, bitch, you crazy Mandarin.
The teams try a bonding exercise.
Backs up against the wall.
Get out, Uncle Ray, get out.
Get up.
Careful.
Stop pushing.
But there's a shocking departure.
Pack your stuff and leave Hell's Kitchen.
And will an explosive dinner service...
Let's go there. We're still struggling. Communication. Get some momentum.
Push one chef...
Have you got a drinking problem?
Too far.
I mean, this is harder than hard.
All next time on A Truly Dangerous.
You may have to go to the hospital.
Get out! Get out! All of you! Get the out of here! Get out!
Highly dramatic.
People are just dropping like flies.
Hell's Kitchen.